Heading home?
Yes.
Let me ask you something. You're a young girl.
Excuse me?
You're the only one around here who doesn't have that stupid look on her face.
What does that mean?
What would your father have to do for you to not want him at your wedding?
My father passed away.
There you go. You'd do anything. What are you doing tonight?
I don't know. What did you have in mind?
Are you drunk? Get your feet off that desk. I need you to work up something for Mohawk.
Oh, I'm sorry. For Mohawk, your quote, man, is Ginsburg.
Let's say you were to do this for me, and on Monday, you explained to Ginsburg and Campbell that I asked you to. Only I asked you sometime last week.
Do you have a brief? Did Ginsburg have a brief?
I never told Ginsburg, okay? You have to remember that. You know about the airline strike, right?
Yes. Why is Mohawk still flying?
Because even though all the other mechanics are on strike, boo-hoo, they need more wrenches or something, Mohawk's mechanics have a side deal, so they have to keep working.
They must love that.
Yeah, well, they're going to love the overtime. American Airlines is taking everything big and giving their Northeast corridor to Mohawk.
So what do you want? How about something like Mohawk breaking the strike one flight at a time? Or maybe fly over the picket line with Mohawk?
Hey, Trotsky, you're in advertising.
Fine. So what's the angle?
Campbell, or I, had this idea that it would be something about, you know, how times are tough and you can't get anywhere. So thank God, Mohawk is offering emergency service.
You don't want to use the word emergency with an airplane?
I don't want to do any of this. I'll see you Monday.
Hold on a second. You want me to work up an entire corporate image campaign for $10?
I can make you do it for nothing. I'm the boss.
You're right. The work is $10. The lie is extra.
Incredible. What do you make a week, sweetheart?
You don't know, huh? That's helpful.
You know, I could fire you.
Great. There's some portfolios in Joan's office. Maybe you could find somebody tonight.
Why are you doing this to me?
Because you're being very demanding for someone who has no other choice. Dazzle me.
Fine. How much you want?
How much you got?
$400.
Give me all of it.
Jesus. It better be good.
Do you want me to take your watch?
I'm on my way out. Are you staying?
Hello. Good night. I have a heart condition, you know.
Believe it or not, I'm not scary. Organ music is scary. What are you doing here?
I told Caroline I wanted to pack my personal things, which I will eventually do, as soon as I figure out why she thought my bar wasn't personal.
Did you try Don's office?
All I found was lighter fluid. I'm not there yet.
Mine's gone.
I don't want to go to a bar. I did that yesterday. Listen, sweetheart, if you don't mind.
I'm not running an errand. I have to go to McCann.
3 days ago.
They screwed up my office. It doesn't matter. They're finally ready.
I'd do it for you.
Would you drink vermouth?
Yes, I'm afraid I would. Look at this. Christmas Day, 1951. Who's Roberta?
I don't know.
Oh, Roberta.
We had our drink. You clearly don't need help. You need an audience.
McCann made you wait. You can make them wait.
I'm not enjoying this. Oh my God. What is this?
It's an octopus pleasuring a lady. It was Cooper's. It was in his office forever. You can have it. You can put it in your office.
Oh, they won't take me seriously.
That's pretty serious. It's 150 years old.
You know I need to make men feel at ease.
Who told you that? So now I gave you something? You can sit tight and keep me company. You think you're gonna have fun like this over there?
This is more attention than I've ever gotten from you.
You should see the floor I'm on. It's a nursing home. What the hell happened?
You're acting like you had nothing to do with this.
I'll have you know, I held this place together.
I know you think that, but you actually sold it. You were supposed to watch out for us.
This business doesn't have feelings. You get bought, you get sold, you get fired. If the account moves, you move.
Even if your name's on the damn door, you should know better than to get attached to some walls.
Well, hopefully I'll have that problem someday.
Okay, hot stuff.
It's exciting. I mean, I know it's going to be challenging, but I needed that. So do you.
In the summer of 44, it was over 100 degrees every day in the Pacific. So we dropped anchor in the Ulithi Lagoon to go for a swim. And you can imagine, the men, it was bedlam. But I couldn't do it.
Can't you swim?
Did I mention I was in the Navy? No, the real problem was it was a two-story drop off our cruiser.
We all have regrets.
No, I did it. I just needed a push. This was a hell of a boat, you know? Come on.
It just looks good now, but it was miserable when you were in it. Trust me.
Is that really how you're gonna remember this place?
This is the one for the road, okay?
You gonna show up drunk at 4 o'clock on your first day? You know any Freemasons?
Come on, once more from the top!
Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. And when you guys are done subscribing, liking, and commenting, I hope you also check out my unproduced screenplays, TV Pilots Volume 1, which is on Amazon and Barnes & Noble. And you can check all that out in the links below. Always remember, be kind, rewatch.